Morning students, I am Dr. T. Mayavan, Associate Professor from the Department of Mechanical Engineering of Panimular Engineering College. The purpose of this session is to explain you about the basics of radiation, that is the fourth unit of your heat and mass transfer, with an aid of some 9 to 10 problems. Radiation is nothing but a mode of heat transfer, of heat energy from a high temperature source to the low temperature source through the electromagnetic waves. So, to identify the amount of heat transfer by radiation, it depends on many factors. Let's see one by one through a simple problem. Consider a surface with a temperature T1, another one is with T2. The emissivity of a first surface is E1 and another one is E2. If you want to identify the heat transfer through radiation, the formula will be sigma into T1 power 4 minus T2 power 4 into A1 and Fn2. This formula is available on your data book at page number 90. Here, first one is this is a constant 5.67 into 10 power minus 8 watt per meter squared Kelvin power 4. It's a Stefan Boltzmann constant for a radiation. And then these two are the temperature which should be represented in Kelvin of these two particular surfaces to be considered. And the next one is surface area of the first one. The first part surface area is represented as A1, and another one is most important factor called the shape factor, which is represented as F12, that is shape factor or view factor. It depends on emissivity of these two surfaces, also the orientation, that is position of first surface with respect to another surface. This may be perpendicular, parallel or inclined. If it is perpendicular, we will get some value. The same surfaces are parallel, then we will get some other value of F12. So before going to calculate F12, we should look at the orientation of these two particular surfaces. Let me explain this with a simple problem. Let's consider a problem. First one, two black square plates of size 2 x 2 meter, they are parallel to each other at a distance of 0.5 meter with a source. One is at 1000 degree, another one is at 500 degree centigrade. If you ask to find out what is the radiation, very simple one, we know that as we discussed earlier, the formula will be sigma into T1 power 4 minus T2 power 4 A1 F12. Here, T1 should be in Kelvin, so convert this given 1000 into Kelvin, so 1000 plus 273, you will get 1273. Similarly, for T2, so sigma is available, T1, T2 is available. Area also available, 2 cross 2 will get 4 meter square. The only thing, how to identify shape factor for this condition? The thing is, they are represented as black surfaces. So, emissivity for black surfaces will be 1. So, both E1 and E2 will be same here, that is equal to 1. Also, these square plates are parallel to each other. So, to identify the shape factor, first we have to look at the graph. At page number data of 99, you can able to identify this graph. These are all the graphs. So this, after this page number 99 up to 120, you can able to see the number of graphs. All the graphs shows the shape factor of black surfaces only based on its orientation. For example, our case, these square plates are parallel to each other at a distance of 0.5. if you closely look at this graph, you can able to see like this. Here you have a x-axis represent ratio is equal to small side divided by distance, and on the inside graph you have number of curves. On the square bracket there you can identify 2, 6 for a square. So you can refer either second graph or sixth graph for your square problems. We know that it's a square problem, so for a simplicity I am taking 2 here. Even I can take 6, but try to get a first one. So 2 represent the square curve, that is these values are only applicable for a square. So here ratio can be calculated as side by distance. Here side represents the square side, which is 2 meter divided by distance between these two is 0.5. so I'll get a ratio of 4. Fix that 4 on your x-axis, go vertically upwards until to get the square curve, and go towards the left to get my shape factor. So this is a shape factor. On your reading you will get nearly 0.62, that is if you closely look at the curve. For a ratio of 4, Against this second curve, I'll get a value of 0.62, slightly above 0.6. So this is the shape factor identified for this orientation. So once you know the F12 value, you can straight away solve the problem. Substitute all the value, constant, temperature 1, temperature 2, area and shape factor what we are getting from this curve. So I get the heat transfer by radiation for this condition is 3.12 × 10⁵ watt. This is the answer for this question. Now I would like to explain the same problem for a gray surface. What is a gray surface? Its emissivity is less than 1. So you may be 0.9 or 0.1, whatever it may be. Assume that, and I would like to explain the same problem for a gray surface. The previous one is, we know that it's a black surface, so the graph represents only the black surface shape factor. So we can just follow the same procedure. But if it is a gray surface, assume that if it is a gray surface with the emissivity value of 0.5 and 0.6. So we can use that same shape factor, but the thing is, it is applicable only for black. So to convert this into a gray surface, you have to substitute here. So at the page number data book 92, you can able to identify a formula like this. That is A1 F12 is equal to 1 by 1 minus E1 by A1 E1 plus 1 by A1 F12 plus 1 minus E2 A2 E2. That is, depends on the value of E1 and E2. This value will be revised. For example, in the previous case, the product of A1 F12 value will be 2.48. Now, we are going to work for a gray surface. So, substitute the D1 value and E2 value here. That is 1 minus E1 is 0.5 divided by area into E1 plus 1 by A1 F12, the previous value, plus 1 minus E2 0.6 is assumed into A2 into E2. So, if you solve this value, you will get a revised A1 F12 value which is equal to 1.2197. If you look at the previous problem, that A1 F12 will be 2.48. Now it is being reduced to nearly 50% value, reduced as 1.2197. Why? Because of the emissivity values. So based on the emissivity value for a gray surface, A1 F12 value getting revised. So if you are substituting this value here, you will get the answer for the second problem. That is, you can use the same problem, sigma T1⁴ minus T2⁴ into A1 F12. But it should be calculated using emissivity value. So as we know that revised value is 1.2197. If you substitute everything, you will get a heat transfer by radiation which is equal to 1.5692 × 10⁵. If you look at the first problem answer, you will get 3.18 × 10⁵. Second problem, nearly 50% is reduced. Why? Because of the emissivity. That is, the amount of energy emitted by the first surface is limited to 50%. Also, the heat energy received by the second surface also limited to 60%. Because of that, the gray surfaces transferred only 50% of its original value. So this is one kind of problem. This is a second kind of problem. In the examination, you can expect either a black surface problem or a gray surface problem. If it is a black surface, you can straight away use the shape factor what you are getting it from the data book. You can use it. If it is a gray surface, get that value, substitute here, get the revised one, and then you can use it on a original formula. So by using this problem, you can able to identify what's the difference between a black surface radiation and a gray surface radiation. Thank you.